Coach's Corner with Don Cherry and Ron McLean. Brought to you by Budweiser Red Lights, bringing buds together one goal at a time.
Back with Grapes here at BC Place.
Well, shots from the points. I mean, I'm not going into it again, but there's two shots from the point. Cover the points, they won't go in.
So Roberto Luongo, Don, what do you think?
Look, I've seen guys treated bad, but let's just go over his history here, okay? Listen to this now. He goes to the seventh game, right? Goes to the seventh game. Sedin's in that, can't score. They quit, they can't score. And all of a sudden, it's his fault. They lose because of him. Then they win the Olympics. And how many times have you heard them say, we won in spite of Luongo? Then they make him captain. Stupidest move of all time. I said they'd take it off him, right? They make him captain. Then they snide Snyder, and they say, look, we'll get rid of the other guy. Don't worry about it. We'll get rid of him. Now he goes over to Europe, and Russia. He said, you're both going to play a game. He plays the game. He gets a shutout. The other guy plays. He comes back here, and now this guy has taken over. You know why? He's too nice a guy. He's easy to do stuff to. I've never seen a guy treated in the last 10 years like that guy.
Dawn to me, Don, watching Lack here, maybe they're thinking they got to put him under all this pressure and move him or something.
Well, they're not going to move him, and I still say they're going to go anywhere. Luongo's going to be the guy in the playoffs.
Totally. And the other thing is the Sedins are going to be the guys and Alex Burrows. And
Sedins,
it's just not working out
right
now.
Listen, let me tell you something. These guys last year signed a contract, $76 million. One's got no goals. One's got nine, and the other guy's got 12. 76. I mean, that is unbelievable. Now, I'm going to show you. Everybody's wondering what's the matter with Burrows. No goals in what, 40 games or something? Ridiculous. Watch. He doesn't know here whether to shoot it, pass it, or wind his watch. And look what happens. Look. There it is there. Let's see it again. See it again. I want to see it again. Watch now. He doesn't know what to do. In the old days when he was dead, he'd have wired it or passed it right away. Indecision, no goals, what, in 40 games, ridiculous. And he plays a power play.
Going to get one today, though.
Is he?
It's coming today.
Oh, yeah, he's your friend now, eh?
Absolutely. Hey, BC boys, Don, we saw the women's team, and crowd went crazy, and BC played such a role.
Well, you know, we're BC here, the people are here going nuts, it's good. Let's see some of the guys here. Of course, my absolute favorite, Jamie Benn from BC, Victoria. He takes a body, hits. Wouldn't he look nice here at BC? Tell you, Shea Weber, watch this, howitzer. Boy, if they could get all the BC guys here, they'd
actually
be
Garrison
right.
Shot kind of reminded, didn't it?
Hammett's doing pretty good. Yeah, I don't know why he didn't play that much, but he was still on the club. Playing pretty good. Duncan Keith. Seabrook should have been here, but Duncan Keith's pretty good. Got the shot on the net. We're not going to show that one, are we? We showed it. Anyhow, there was it, and we got the BC boys, and listen, guys, a lot of good players, and there we are. We won it again. We love seeing that.
Don, following in the footsteps of one of the great teams of all time, 67 Vancouver Canucks.
Now, listen, wait a minute. Hold it. I want to tell you something. I played out here, and we went through the playoffs, never lost the game. We were a better club, and I was, look at that right there. We were in Burnaby, and I lived in the Admiral Hotel with Jimmy McKenney. I kind of look stupid there, though, don't I? And we lived with Jimmy McKenney and Mark Rium. And there's when we won. That's me in the left-hand corner. We went through the whole. That's Annie Bathgate next to us. Went through the whole playoffs and never lost a game. That's when there were winners here.
It's funny. Just seeing Garrison's blast remind of Shea Weber. The shot that went off Kevin BX's hand.
Oh,
is like
to say it, eh?
Well, it happened to Doug Harvey. It can happen to Kevin. Not bad company to be in.
No, but listen, what he was trying to do is get it out of there. Don't bring it up. And Kevin Bietzka, if more guys would play like Kevin Bietzka, they wouldn't be in the trouble. I'll tell you one thing. They better get going. Both these teams now are
good. It's a good game, though, Don. The ice is good. You can tell that. And the other thing, you watched the Minnesota game the other night. Vancouver was credited with over 32 hits.
Well, I
but
don't
it
know.
Wasn't the same as today.
It was more rubouts or something like that. But listen, both of these teams, we got to get Ottawa in there. We got to get Vancouver. We got to get Canadian teams in here. I hope they both make it because we got to have more Canadian teams in here.
All right, Tegan and Sarah are going to perform. You already met Sarah McLaughlin. I know you've been feted by Gary Bettman, so it's been a pretty.
I was what?
Feted. Are they going to the Olympics? Did you ask them?
No, we're not going to the Olympics. I told you, we're not going to the Olympics.
Through the eyes of hockey players, a great way to CBC on CBC.
Coach's Corner on CBC. brought to you by Budweiser Red Lights, bringing Buds together one goal at a time.